Legendary, the incomparable, the man who started it all, one of our favorites around here. You just heard some Alice Cooper, what I am calling the official theme song of the 2016 election cycle, Lost in America, the name of that one. A tune, well, I'll admit it, I lifted off this week's Haunted Cabaret.
Well, and I am pleased to offer you the lift.
So, George, I had the pleasure of checking out, speaking of incomparable bands, this is an incomparable local band. I had the pleasure of checking out NMC last night at Firehouse 13, Necrophiliac Meat Circus.
I know it. That's one of those things that I wanted to be there, but I'm hoping you're going to tell me it was a lousy show.
No, it was awesome.
Of course it was.
They kicked. They nailed it. And, you know, they're, of course, Alice Cooper defined as shock rock. Necrophiliac Meat Circus definitely defined as shock rock. More of a treat now because they only play occasionally. But as they were throwing toilet paper around the club and as they were throwing heads into the audience, it really got me to thinking if people can actually be shocked anymore. And I guess this is an idea that's been going around for years and years. You know, is there anything that is shocking? Now, for that crowd, people came specifically for a shock rock show, but
right.
And I don't know if they had the wrong night, but there was a very lovely couple in front of me, dressed to the nines, that walked into the club, listened for a couple minutes, saw Necrophiliac Meat Circus on stage, then they asked for their cover back, and they exited the club.
Now, they were properly shocked.
That was...
I guess whether you're going to be shocked or not depends on... How would you put this? It depends on the compatibility of the surroundings with the potential shocking.
Right.
I think the best way to shock the necro crowd would have been for the band to show up on stage in, you know, probably suits and ties and play a very laid back set of, you know, maybe Glenn Campbell standards or something like that. You know, that would have been shocking.
Well, especially since that crowd came for a shock rock. They came for
exactly.
A horror show.
Right. The thing is that to shock somebody, you have to do the unexpected. You can't just, you know, give them something more shocking than last time.
Just an average show.
Just,
yeah.
You can't. Well, just like a horror movie. You can't scare anybody at a horror movie anymore just by building up the horror music and, you know, having somebody jump out of the shadows.
Yeah.
The best way to shock somebody at a horror movie is, I forget which movie it was, but this poor girl ran out screaming. because they didn't play the music before the Killers.
Well, you got to know when it's going to happen.
Of course. I mean, that's, yeah.
I was, you know, as I mentioned at the top of the show, having some health issues, so I was kind of cordoned to the house the other day, and I had the misfortune. Well, I should say, shouldn't say the misfortune, because I watched Jaws. That was awesome.
That's
then I had
awesome.
The misfortune of watching Jaws 2, Jaws 3.
That's not 3. Quite as awesome. Nah, going down the ladder.
And some other, was there a weird, like, return to Jaws or something in there that wasn't numbered, but it was Jaws-based? And, I got to say, I sat through the whole thing.
Was Jaws 3 was awful. The one where the shark came after Ellen Brody?
Yeah.
Okay, that's Jaws
3. It was awful. I mean, it was just awful.
Oh, yeah, that's... Yeah, and I think you're right. There was some kind of Jaws 4. It wasn't a cinema release, but there was some kind of a Jaws follow-up to... Yeah.
That kind of got me also, you know, with Necro and watching Jaws the other day, got me thinking about what is shocking these days and what can happen, because I remember as a kid, I was afraid to go in my backyard swimming pool due to Jaws. I just, you know, I didn't know any better. But now watching the pacing of the movie, I mean, you would never see that pacing in a modern suspense or a modern horror movie.
No, because the focus groups would tell the director that they were getting impatient.
Yeah.
So, I don't know. Shocking. Let me think here.
If you don't mind me chiming in there, guys.
Oh, chime right in.
If you're going to do a shock rock show, or if you're going to try to shock somebody...
Well, we're not talking just... musically now, we're just talking shock in general speaking.
You have to base it upon the level of which these people have been shocked in the past.
Well, that's what I was saying when I...
I mean, if you got a bunch of fifth graders and you show them throwing around a simulated head, it's going to freak them out. However, unfortunately for our age group and our demographics, we've seen it before. It's not that shocking. We've become numb to this. So you have to keep stepping up your game till you're almost to the point of human sacrifice.
Well, that's why I said you have to match up, you know, the setting with shocking.
Which I don't necessarily have an issue with, because I've always been more of a fan of campy type horror anyway. I like the cheesy, shocking yet cheesy B movie. The acting is terrible, but there's a good storyline.
Well, you're not there to get scared. You're not there to be scared, though. You know, Chuckles has said the same thing to me. In other words, you guys enjoy the campiness. In other words, the goal of watching that movie is not to come away from it with a feeling of dread, a feeling of not wanting to turn off the lights, a feeling of being unsettled about your life from that point on. That's a different thing. That's what's very hard to accomplish.
Yeah. No, what I'm saying is you have to go above and beyond. It's almost like your work expectations. You have to go above and beyond what's expected,
right? But I think
in order to get that response,
right?
But
I think what Tony's saying is there such a thing anymore as an above and beyond?
Now, the last one I can remember,
it depends on the people.
The last one I can remember is The Conjuring. I went to the theater to see The Conjuring, and as a 30-something, I went home and I turned the lights on in the house, and you know, I finally snapped myself out of it. I'm a grown ass man, you know. It was just a movie, but. Yeah, that one had some elements that you kind of took home with you.
And then there's a difference, too, between shock, you know, like, oh, my God, you know, wet your pants and start screaming, shock, and being unsettled, jumping in your seat.
Right.
When we're talking about shock.
Driving home and freaking yourself out.
Yeah, we're talking about, like you said, you don't want to go swimming anymore. You know, you don't want to take a shower anymore. You know, as happened after Alfred Hitchcock's movie Psycho. You know, there were a lot of smelly people walking around for months and sometimes years afterward.
We have a lot of friends that smell that bad that have never seen
Psycho.
It's called halitosis. Well, this kind of dovetails perfectly into my next tune, because one of the more shocking things for other generations was, well, what I saw again last night when Necrophiliac Meat Circus is Androgyny. And unfortunately, one of my favorites, he passed away in 2009, Lux Interior, from the cramps. One of the shocking things about him and Iggy Pop was the just straight up androgyny. Now, these guys are perfectly straight, too, and just straight up androgyny.
Yeah, which annoys the living hell out of me, because every so often I'll be sexually attracted to one of these androgynous people, and they always turn out to be straight.
And the most embarrassing thing is when you meet their wife and she's smoking hot.
Worse and worse.
Well, we're a few days late for our little tribute to Lux Interior here. He passed away on February 4th, 2009. Incidentally, this weekend on February 13th at dusk on Harris Ave in Providence, they're going to have the Lux Lives tribute, and it's going to kind of be a full night dedicated to the life of Lux Interior. And the Ramones and the Cramps were, for young Tony Jones, they were my life. And it's as they start to die off one by one, it really makes you appreciate what their music did for you growing up. So a little politically incorrect Cramp song up next for you.
Is there any other kind?
Here's The Natives Are Restless right here on the Tony Jones Show.